space, time, life itself. The secrets of the cosmos lie through the wormhole.
Pick up a rose, take in its scent. Feast your eyes on the crimson of its petals. Feel the prick of its thorn on your finger. These sensations are what ground us in reality. But what if they're just fabricated? What if we are merely players in someone else's video game? The Big Bang just the moment someone flipped the switch and turned on our universe. In the movie The Matrix, that was one way to see the truth behind a fake reality. Take the red pill. Are you ready for it?
Jesse Schell knows a lot about video games. He teaches students at Carnegie Mellon University how to design them. He appreciates the enormous effort it would take to create all the details of our world inside a computer. The most sophisticated video games are still played on two-dimensional screens, like the one you're watching now.
Creating the illusion of three dimensions on flat screens is much simpler than actually creating real three-dimensional space that we can move around in. So programming 3D space as we know it would be many, many orders of magnitude more difficult than anything we know how to do right now.
Jesse and other video game designers are pretty good at simulating the way objects move through space. They use Newton's laws of gravity and motion, just as the designers of our world would.
The balls have weight, air is moving around them, electrical charges are increasing and decreasing on the surface of each ball, and even if I'm a little bit off, the laws of physics are still intact. But if the rules themselves are off, then we'll know right away that something's wrong, that it's not an accurate simulation of our world.
Making a believable reality would take far more than perfect programming of the way objects look and move.
You'd have to program all the other senses too. Sound, smell, taste, and touch, and all the subtle variations. And if even one small thing was off, like say this coffee having the same taste and temperature as this cereal, you'd know right away that something was terribly wrong.
How would you computerize taste? Or program the feel of soft grass underfoot? Even the air we breathe is filled with gases, water molecules, dust particles, and pollen. At Carnegie Mellon's Entertainment Technology Center, Jesse is trying to make simulations as immersive as possible. In what he calls the cave, a moving platform adds to the visual experience.
But sometimes the simulation is too much for the computer, and we get glitches, just like in a video game. It's possible that if we were making a simulation of the real world, that the same thing could happen.
When a computer can't keep up with the visuals it needs to render, you often see a defect called screen tearing. We've never seen that in our world, but not all glitches would be visible to people on the inside.
If the simulation freezes, then the people who are in it might not know, because it could freeze for 1,000 years, and anyone who was part of the simulation would also be frozen in a state of suspended animation, so that when it started up again, it would be absolutely seamless to them, and they would never know.
If someone else has created us inside their computers, then they must also have built programs for all of our mental abilities. Our imaginations, our emotions, and the thoughts running through our heads every time we engage in conversation.
As humans, we get so much information from talking that an accurate conversation program is crucial.
What did you want to be when you grew up?
A fireman.
A fireman? That's noble. So either A, you've got a death wish, or B, you like to stare at fire.
And it only takes us a split second to notice a problem with the conversation. So you can imagine the challenge of simulating 7 billion people all talking together at once.
Jesse thinks our creators could be using a few shortcuts to handle this heavy load. Concepts already used by today's game programmers.
You could make just a few people be active players and then surround them with billions of much simpler characters. Or another thing you could do is only put detailed simulations where I'm looking at a given time. If I'm looking just to one place, just put all the focus over there and make everything else around me just kind of a blur.
Maybe you are the only active player in this game you call your life. Everyone else exists only when you are paying attention. Your program would be the only one running all the time, even when you sleep.
Dreams are already a kind of simulated reality. So to program dreams, you'd have to create a virtual reality within a virtual reality.
If our world is an incredibly complex computational creation, what does that say about its creators? What must their reality be like if spawning an entire universe is just a game?